Hello friends, welcome to the video lecture series on digital image processing. I am Dr. Dafda, and in this 13th video class of DIP, we will understand what is histogram, how to perform histogram equalization in digital image processing, and of course its implementation in MATLAB. So as usual, starting with the name itself, what is histogram? Histogram is a graphical representation of image data, and equalization means normalization. So hence, for histogram equalization, we will be equalizing the probability of occurrence of different gray levels for a digital image. So let us start. The histogram of images provide a global description of the appearance of an image. The information that is obtained from histograms is enormous. By definition, histogram of an image represents the relative frequency of occurrence of various gray levels in an image. For the histogram, the x-axis has the gray levels and the y-axis has the number of pixels in each gray level. The histogram of a digital image with intensity levels in the range 0 to L minus 1 is a discrete function h of rk is equal to nk. And you know that rk or r is your input intensity level. So histogram of rk is equal to the number of pixels for different gray levels nk. So for h of rk is equal to nk, rk is the kth intensity value and nk is the number of pixels in the image with intensity rk. So histograms are the basis for numerous spatial domain processing techniques. Histogram manipulation can be used for image enhancement, and we can control the quality of an image by normalizing or equalizing the histogram values to a flat profile. So this one, third one, is our original image. So as you can see from the image, it is a very dull image. It is a very low contrast image. So majority of the pixels are towards this region of the intensity values. Now see figure 1. So it is a very dark image as compared to this original image. So from this image itself, we can see that this image is a dark image and majority of the pixels are concentrated towards the lower end of the intensity level, and we know that lower end is black, that is 0, and higher end is white, that is L minus 1. So the second image is a very bright image, and we can see from the histogram that most of the pixels are concentrated towards the brighter end of the image. And if we want to make this image a high contrast image, not a bright image, neither a dark image, then when we perform histogram equalization or histogram processing on this image and make the probability of occurrence of that gray level equal or equalized, we obtain a high contrast image like this. So here you can see that the pixels are evenly distributed throughout all gray levels, and hence this image is a high contrast image. So for the histogram, the x-axis has the gray levels and the y-axis has the number of pixels in each gray level or frequency of occurrence of gray level. So from these figures, we can see that histogram can provide the description of the type of the image. Say for example, this is our image and these are different gray levels which are occurring in the image. So from this image, we can see that the maximum value of gray level is 7. Hence, this image is a 3-bit image since 2 raised to 3 is equal to 8 and this is k. So k is equal to 3, that means it is a 3-bit image. So rather than an 8-bit image, we have chosen a 3-bit image for the ease of understanding. Now you can see that for this image, these are different pixels which are shown over here in boxes, and these are the gray levels of the pixels. So for histogram, we note down the different gray levels. So as it is a 3-bit image, 2 raised to 3 is equal to 8. And hence, we have gray levels starting from 0 to 7. Now let us see the frequency of occurrence or the number of pixels. 0 in this image is occurring only once here. Therefore, we will note down 1. The number of pixels having gray level 0 is only 1. The number of pixels or frequency of occurrence of gray level 1 is not present in this image, as you can see here. And hence, we will note down 0 for 1. 2 is occurring 1, 2, 2 times. Hence, we will be writing 2. 3 is occurring 1, 2, 3, 4 times. And hence, we will be writing 4. 4 is occurring 4 times. 1, 2, 3 and 4. 5 is occurring 5 times. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. 6 is also occurring 5 times. So 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. And 7 is occurring 4 times, as you can see, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So in this way, we write down the histogram in a tabular form. In the graphical form, we mention the histogram with x-axis as the gray levels and y-axis the number of pixels in each gray level. So 0 is occurring 1 time. So for 0, we will write 1 or we will plot 1. 1 is occurring 0 time. So 1, 0. 2 is occurring 2 times. So 2 is occurring 2 times. 3 is occurring 4 times. 3 is occurring 4 times. 4 is also occurring 4 times. 5 and 6 is occurring 5 times. 7 is occurring 4 times. So this is how you plot a histogram for a particular image. So histogram of an image shows the frequency of occurrence of different gray levels. Let's go ahead and understand different steps for histogram equalization or histogram processing. Let us take one other example for understanding histogram equalization. See, the histogram is already given like this, that 0 is having 70 number of pixels, 100, 2 gray level 40 pixels, 3 gray level 60 pixels, 4 0, 5 80, 6 10 and 7 40. So for performing histogram equalization, first of all note down the gray level values. So as the maximum gray level that is mentioned or shown over here is 7, that means it is a 3-bit image. So we will note down the gray level starting from 0 to 7. So here L is equal to 8 or L minus 1 is equal to 7. And we will note down the number of pixels NK adjacent to the gray levels. So 0, 70 pixels, 100 pixel and so on. We will note down all the values for number of pixels. After noting down all the values of number of pixels, we will add all the number here. Adding all these values, we get N is equal to 400. Next, we have to find out the PDF, that is probability density function of different gray levels. So probability density function is given by NK divided by N, and here total N is 400. So this small n is also equal to M cross N, you can say. So NK divided by N, 70 divided by 400 will give 0.175. 100 divided by 400 will give 0.25. 40 divided by 400 will give 0.1. 60 divided by 400 will give 0.15 and so on. We will obtain different probability density function values. So now we need to equalize this PDF values for histogram equalization. So first we will find out the CDF values by summation of PDF values. The first value of PDF is kept as it is in the CDF, that is 0.175. Next, add this 0.175 to the next value of PDF, that is 0.175 plus of 0.25 will give us 0.425. Next, 0.425 plus of next PDF value will give us 0.525. Next, add 0.525 to 0.15 to obtain 0.675. Add 0.675 to 0, you will get 0.675 again. Again, add this 0.675 to 0.2, you will get 0.875. Add 0.875 to 0.025, you will get 0.9. Add 0.9 to 0.1 and finally you will get 1. So you know that the maximum value will be 1. So many a times, rather than plotting this original histogram, even the PDF of the histogram is plotted, or a normalized histogram can be plotted. Next is, once you obtain the CDF values, you multiply the CDF values by L minus 1. So you know here your L is 8, 2 raised to 3, which is equal to 8, and L minus 1 is 7. That means you have to multiply CDF by 7, and multiplying by 7 you will get these values. 0.175 into 7 will give you 1.22, 0.425 into 7 will give you 2.97 and so on. You will get different values up to 7. Now these are the new gray levels which you are getting, but you have to round off these values. So 1.22 is near to 1, so it will be rounded off to 1. 2.97 is near to 3, so it is rounded off to 3. 3.67 is higher than 3.5, therefore it is rounded up to 4. 4.72 is rounded up to 5. 4.72 again is rounded up to 5. 6.12 is rounded to 6. 6.3 is less than 6.5, so it is rounded to 6, and 7 is rounded to 7. So these are the new gray level values which you are obtaining compared to the old gray level values which you had. So in the next step, make new histogram table. So for making this new histogram table, you just consider the first column, the second column, and the last column. So first column is your gray level or old gray level, 0 to 7. Second column is the number of pixels, 70 up to 40. Your new gray level, the last column of your table, you have to mention here, which is 1, 3, 4, 5, 5, 6, 6, 7. And once you have written these three columns, now forget this old gray level values and only concentrate on the second and the third column and note down the new number of pixels NK. So here it is 70, we will write down 70 as it is. Here it is 100, so for new gray level 3, the number of pixels will be equal to 100. 40 will be written over here. Now for gray level 5, new gray level 5, you can see that there are two values of new gray level 5, 60 plus 0. So you have to add 60 plus 0 to obtain new number of pixels, 60. Similarly, for new gray level value 6, you have 80 plus 10. So you have to add 80 plus 10 to obtain new number of pixels or frequency of occurrence equal to 90. And for 7, it is 40. So we will mention 40 as it is. So now you have to concentrate on these two values as your new histogram values and plot it. So as it is a 3-bit image, we'll be plotting from 0 to 7 as it is. You can see here that there are no values for gray level 0. So for gray level 0, we'll not be having any values. For gray level 1, the number of pixels or frequency of occurrence is 70. So for 1, it is 70. For 2, again, there are no values. So 2 is 0. For 3, 100. So for 3, 100. For 4, 40. 4 gray level is having 40 pixels. 5, 60. 5 is having 60. 6, 90. 6 is having 90 number of pixels. And 7, 40. And 7 is again having number of pixels 40. So you can again add all these number of pixels. It will again come out to be same, that is 400. So now you can compare the old histogram and the new histogram. You can see that the old histogram was more concentrated towards the darker end or lower end, and the new histogram is almost equally distributed throughout. Hence, what we have done is we have equalized the histogram, or we have equalized the probability of occurrence of different gray levels in the histogram, and this is known as histogram equalization or histogram processing or histogram modeling. So I hope it is clear. So when you perform histogram equalization, if this is our original image, which you can say is a little bit dark image, and many of the values are towards the dark end, as you can see here, towards zero. So when we equalize the histogram, we obtain the histogram equalized image like this, and you can see the histogram of this image, that is having a almost flat profile. So now you can see that the image has become enhanced, and previously it was dark, but now it has become a bright image. So histogram equalization is used for contrast enhancement as well as increasing the brightness of very dark images. When you perform histogram equalization for the inbuilt MATLAB image pout, which is a very dull image, and you can see the histogram of this image, which is concentrated towards the mid. After performing histogram equalization, the image becomes a high contrast and good bright image like this, and you can see the histogram is equally distributed. Let us perform this in MATLAB. So initially I am reading a image maulik.png, and as my image is a color image, I am converting it to grayscale image using RGB to gray command, and I am showing my original image. Now for showing the histogram of the original image, I have used imhist of I, that is my original image. So imhist is the inbuilt MATLAB command for plotting the histogram of the image. Similarly, for histogram equalization of the image, I have used histeq, that is inbuilt MATLAB command for equalizing the histogram of an image. So I am taking a new variable j, which is equal to histeq I, and I am subplotting my histogram equalized image and the histogram imhist of histogram equalized image. So let us run this program in MATLAB. So you can see this is my original image, which is a bit dark image, and many values are concentrated towards the darker end, as you can see from the histogram. And after performing histogram equalization using histeq, I will obtain an enhanced image, a good contrast and a brighter image like this. And the histogram profile, you can see, is almost flat. Here the values which were very low are now become flat because we have taken the values from the darker end and equalized the image. Let us run the same program using inbuilt MATLAB image, that is pout.tif. So I have disabled my image as well as RGB to gray command because pout is already a grayscale image. And let us run this program again. So you can see that this pout image is a dull image, a very low contrast image, or a washed out type image whose majority of the pixels are located towards the mid end of the grayscale. When we perform the histogram equalization on this image, you can see that image has become a high contrast image and the grayscale values are normalized throughout the whole image. So from this example, you can see that how powerful histogram equalization is. And you may have a question in your mind that is histogram equalization always good? Let us obtain the answer by using cameraman image. When we run the program using cameraman image, you can see that the original image was better as compared to the histogram equalized image. So this is your original image and its histogram. So you can see the quality of this original image and the contrast levels which are present. Whereas when you histogram equalize this original cameraman image, you obtain an image like this. So of course you can see that the histogram is equalized to a flat profile, but the image has become bad. So this concludes that histogram equalization is not always good. Then you may have a question in your mind that what is the solution to that? So the solution to that is histogram specification or histogram matching that we will be learning in the next video class. So remember, histogram equalization is a very powerful process but not always good. Now you can even perform the histogram showing and histogram equalization without using imhist or histeq command as I have shown in this program. So here I have applied the same mathematics that I have explained you earlier in this class for equalizing the histogram using the PDF and CDF. So when you run the program, you can see this was our original image and the histogram of the original image, and this is our histogram equalized image and the histogram of equalized image. So you can even show the histogram and perform histogram equalization without even using imhist or histeq as shown in this program. So that is all for this video class. In the next video class, we will understand histogram specification or histogram matching. Thank you very much.